come again in online sessions of oil, hydraulic and pneumatic. Myself, Praveen Jinjala from LGN Institute of Engineering and Technology. In today's session, we will discuss about the types of automation. In previous lecture, we have also discussed about the what is automation, advantages of automation, disadvantages of automation, and also we have discussed general overview of types of automation or what is the requirement of automation. In today's session, we will discuss about the what is automation and examples of automation in hydraulic and pneumatic field. So, let's start our session. Types of automation. First type of automation is fixed type automation, means system in which sequence of processing or assembly operation is fixed by the equipment configuration. Means there will be fixed in output, as like the operation in car or in automobile sector for production in assembly line. There will be sequence will be fixed, as like the first car, second car, third car. So the old sequence will be fixed and utilizations of automation for production. So it's called fixed automation. In fixed automation, the sequence are usually simple. So it is advantages for mass production. Features of automation, initial investment is required higher compared to the simple production. So this is the disadvantages of fixed automation. Second is high production rate. This is the advantages of fixed automation. Means there will be mass production. We can mass produce the many component. It's like the same model of car, same model of bike, same configuration product. So fixed automation generally used for mass production. Next is relatively inflexible in accordance product changes. We cannot change the product. If we take one example, it's like the productions of car. So we have to produce the same model of car or same dimensions of car. We cannot change the dimension or we cannot change the outer diameter of the car by utilizations of fixed automation. Fixed automation means there will be fixed in output. You have to produce the same quantity throughout the production. Example of fixed automation is mechanized assembly or machining transfer line. This is also machining transfer line. There will be same product will be output or same product will be produced. So it's called fixed automation. Second is programmable automation, means equipment can be produced by changing diameter. So it is advantages compared to the fixed automation. In programmable automation, there will be program is required for production. We have to utilize the computer for program, as like the M code, G code for preparation for particular component. Example of programmable automation we can give as like the NC machine or CNC machine. We can produce the large component by changing the product. And new product can be prepared to produce the new production. So the by utilizations of programmable automation, we can change the diameter or change the outer diameter of any component. Next is feature of programmable automation. High initial investment required for programmable automation, as like the required the special computer, any programming software, special skill person required for programming. Low production rate relative to the fixed automation, because in fixed automation there will be only for one program. But compared to the fixed automation, in programmable automation, we have to require the special programming for particular component. If we change the component, so we have to require the special programming for that component. Flexible to deal with the change in product configuration, so it is advantageous compared to the fixed automation. Mostly suitable for batch production. So the programmable automation will be advantageous in batch production. Third is flexible automation. If we require the variety of component, let's take one example. If we produce the rocket, so we have to utilize the flexible automation, because there will be no similar component. Different time has a different component and different production rate. So we have to utilize the flexible automation. And it is extension of programmable automation and capable of producing a variety of product or variety of part with virtually no time lost of changeover from the one product to the next. So it is advantageous compared to the programmable and fixed automation. Next is feature of flexible automation, high initial investment for the custom engine system. We have to require the initial investment because the initially require the many component, electronic component, different types of sensor, different types of hydraulic and pneumatic system component. So it is initial cost will be higher. Continuous production of variety mixture of product. So by utilization of flexible automation, we can continuously produce the different variety of product. Medium production rate compared to the programmable and fixed automation. Next is flexible to the deal with the product design variation. We can produce the various component, different diameter, different configuration. Example of flexible automation is like the productions of rocket, space application, component, or we can also say the flexible manufacturing system. It is also one type of example of flexible automation. Now we will discuss about the relation of fixed, programmable and flexible automation. We can compare with respect to the product variety and product quantity. So we can also compare the three types of automation. If we require the higher quantity, so we cannot achieve the variety of product. If we require the variety of product, so we cannot achieve the quantity of product. So all automation has on advantages and disadvantages. We can select the different automation particular requirement or particular application. First, we discuss about the fixed automation. In fixed automation, production quantity will be higher, but variety of product will be lower. While the in flexible automation, production of quantity and variety of production will be medium, not a higher or not a lower. But compared to the flexible automation, programmable automation has a product variety will be higher, but it has a lower production quantity. So according to the requirement or according to the application, we have to select the different types of automation as like the fixed, programmable and flexible. Flexible has a medium, not a higher production quantity or not a higher variety of product and not a higher quality compared to the fixed and programmable automation. So our requirement, we have to select the different automation. Now we will discuss about the automations in fluid power system. How can we convert or how can we utilize the automation in fluid power industry, as like in hydraulic industry or in pneumatic industry? Here the many component used in automation in fluid power system. First component will be reference, means we have to set our the quantity and quality of any product. Then after the signal will be goes to the amplifier. Amplifier will be amplify the electronic signal. It will be supply the signal to the controller, and controller will be control, or it will be change the our output or our input for our quality of product. Controller will be utilized for the hydraulic system or pneumatic system, and it will be supply the signal to the processor, and processor will be change the our input, and final input there will be one feedback system. So signal will be passed from our output to the inlet signal. It will be positive or it can be negative signal. So by the utilization of feedback system, input will be compared, our preset value and our feedback system. If there will be no error, so it will be passed the simple signal. And if there will be any error, if our design signal will be changed, so it will be supply or it will be pass the signal to the amplifier, then after the controller, processor, and our input will be changed, and final our output will be changed, and again feedback system will be supplied to signal to the input. So the continuously this type of system will be circulate, and we can get the proper quantity or proper quality of any product by feedback system. So then automation in fluid power system utilize the many component, amplifier, comparator, feedback system, controller, different types of actuator, different types of signals, input or comparator, which will be compare the input and output signal. So the by utilization of automation, we can improve the quality of any product. Now we will be discuss about the hydraulic and pneumatic servo system. First of all, we discuss about the what is servo or servo mechanism. Servo or servo mechanism is feedback control system. It is also from automation. So we can say the servo or servo mechanism is feedback control system which measure its own output and force, the output to quickly and accurately follow the command signal. So it's called servo mechanism or servo. It will be measure the own output and force, and it will be quickly supply signal to accurate the command signal. Servo mechanism can be designed to the control the almost all physical quantities, as like the it is also used for the measure the velocity, force, pressure, temperature, electrical voltage or current. So the servo system generally used for measurement of on signal, and it will be supply the signal according to the test. Now we are taking one example of hydraulic and pneumatic servo system. Here the many components, and also here the one types of feedback system. First is commander or signal input. If there will be any error, so it will be supply the servo amplifier and regulator. Regulator will be supply the servo valve, then after the servo valve will be change its position, or it will be change the outlet in form of electronic, in form of fluid, in form of pressurized liquid. Then after it will be supply the actuator, and actuator will be change the output according to the received signal. Here also one types of external disturbance, so there will be positive and negative. It will be supply the mechanical load, and our output will be created. If the output signal will be again supply feedback transmitted to the input signal, and input also will be compared with the precise value and feedback signal, and if there will be any error, so it will be also pass the signal to the servo amplifier and regulator, then after the servo valve, actuator, external source, and then after the mechanical load. So this is the one type of automation used in fluid power system or in hydraulic and pneumatic system. Now we are taking one example of servo fluid system for linear motion. So this is the double acting double rod cylinder. This is the 4x3 direction control valve. This is the pump. This is the relief valve. And this is the return line. If we start our pump, so it will be fluid in first position will be passed to the first side of cylinder, and second side fluid will be passed to the reservoir, and our cylinder will be start to in extraction. So we can also control the motions of this cylinder by utilizations of automation. Means there will be some quantity will be measured or will be control our linear motion by utilizations of physical contact type or by utilizations of non-contact type, as like the any sensors. It will be supply the output signal to the feedback signal amplifier. It will be again supplied to the input or comparator. It will be compare the input signal and precise value. Then after it will be also work as a servo amplifier, and it will be supply signal to the servo valve. It's called electro-hydraulic servo valve, and according to this signal, this valve position will be changed in first position, second or third position. So the by utilizations of servo mechanism, we can also control the linear motion. Second example is servo fluid system for rotary motion. Same is like here the 4x3 direction control valve. This is the bi-directional hydraulic motor. If you supply in first position pressurized fluid, so motor will be start to in rotation. So according to we have to require the different rotation speed and different torque. So the according to the requirement or according to the precise value, signal will be passed from motor to the transducer and transducer to the servo controller. Then after the servo controller will be supply the signal to the servo amplifier, and amplifier will be supplied to the direction control var. So the according to the requirement or according to the our precise value, it will be changed the whole position, or it will be changed the as like the hydraulic motor RPM or hydraulic motor torque. So according to the this requirement, we can utilize the different automation in hydraulic and pneumatic system. So this session was about the different types of automation, how to implement of automation in hydraulic and pneumatic system, and which type of generally component use in automation in hydraulic and pneumatic system. Thank you.